Watermaker photos look flawless by matching skin tones perfectly in just a few clicks. Today in this video, I'm gonna show you the easiest and quick way to match skin tones using Photoshop. So let's get started. Alright, here is my original photo where I will apply the skin tones adjustment, and this one is my reference photo with the perfect skin tones that I want to match. Okay, so first create a curves adjustment layer just above your original layer and then click on the layer thumbnail, not on the mask. This one is very, very important to make sure we are adjusting the curve itself. And now look at this three eyedropper closely. Each one targets different spot in your image. Okay, the first one, the filled with black color. This one is for shadows or dark areas. And then the second one, filled with gray color. This one is for midtones. And the third one, filled with white color. And this eyedropper tool is for the highlighted bright or white part of your photo. And now double click on the highlight eyedropper tool to bring the color picker. Now let's zoom in and okay, that's fine. And click on the brightest part of your reference photo, brightest part of the skin. So let's click here and then hit OK. Save the new target colors as default? No. And now click on the brightest area of the skin of your original photo. Okay, so hit here. Done. The first one is done. And now again double click on the midtone eyedropper tool. And now just click on the midtone areas of your reference photo, just like this. And hit OK. No. Now click on the midtone skin area on your original photo. This is usually somewhere between shadows and highlights. You can try different spots to find the best result. Okay, just like this. I think it looks good. I think this one looks good. Now follow the same process. Double click on the shadow eyedropper tool and click on the darkest spot of your reference photo. Hit OK. And now click on the dark area of the skin of your original photo, just like this. Look at this. Almost done. But the adjustment applies across the whole image. But you probably want it on the skin areas only. Okay. So now click on the mask here and paint with a black brush to remove the effect from where you don't want. Just like this. And that's it. Here is the before and after. You can reduce the opacity from here to make it more realistic. I think 70 to 75 works just fine. Look at this. You can reduce it more. Let's go with 65. So here is the before and after. It looks just perfect, just like our reference photo. So that's it. I hope you love this video. If you did, hit the like button, leave your comments, and don't forget to subscribe.